So it is Sunday, May 1st, and it is 8:15 in the morning. As you can see, I am not in my apartment. I am at my parents' house in their guest room. Basically, this is where I have set up shop for the past month or so since Zaya has been born. Yes, this is my first weekly vlog check-in since Zaya has been born. She's right there, naked, about to get a bath. But yeah, I'm starting to vlog again for the first time since the last time I posted. So that's pretty exciting. And this stinky monkey is about to get a bath.
Hit me a big towel. We're gonna make this quick and dirty. Because we can't try to be soft with you, because you holler anyway.
I have to make it show terribly.
I hate the bath time. Usually she screams and screams and
You're
screams.
Good girl.
You're not screaming.
You're good girl. Yeah. Nice and slippery. Nice and slippery. Nice and slippery.
Okay. There you go. Does that feel good, girl?
Rinse, rinse, rinse. Rinse, rinse, rinse.
Keep your neck to it.
Nope.
Come here.
Good job. First time we didn't have screaming during the bath. Are you getting lotioned?
Bath time is done. We are all dressed and fed and pleasant now. But anyway, what I was saying is, yes, this is my first day back vlogging since I've had Zaya. I've obviously been taking a lot of little pictures and video clips of her this whole time.
What are you doing? What are you saying?
But I haven't tried actually like vlogging my whole day. So this is the first day of me trying that. We're going to see how it goes. We're going to see how this goes in general, because you guys know that I previously said that it's kind of hard just to vlog, period. Just one person trying to vlog themselves. Now I'm one person trying to vlog myself with the baby in the other hand. So we're going to see how much I actually am able to film and how, I don't know. We're just going to see how this goes. I'm going to try my best. And yeah, but today we are going to be, it's May 1st and Mother's Day is next Sunday on May 8th. But today we're going to be celebrating Mother's Day early because my grandma is going to be out of town next week. So we want to celebrate with her this week. And so my grandma, my aunt, my mom, and me, and Zaya, are going to go out for lunch today. So, and that'll really be her first like real outing, because we've taken her to a bunch of doctor's appointments, but she hasn't like been out to just like a restaurant or just like a regular place like that. So today will be her first little outing, and we're gonna see how that goes, if she behaves in the restaurant or if I'm gonna be the annoying mom with the screaming baby in the restaurant. But I think she'll be pretty good. She usually is pretty well behaved. I'm gonna give you to your grandma so I can get dressed. Let's go have some grandma time. But yeah, by the time y'all are watching this vlog, you probably will already have seen my labor and delivery story and like a couple of other videos. And especially if you follow me on Snapchat, you probably already know this. But basically, I have set up camp in my mom's guest room because I knew I was going to be staying here for at least a week after I had Zaya, because obviously I wasn't just going to go back to my apartment by myself and try to recover by myself. You know, like the first week or two after you give birth is pretty rough and you need like a lot of help and support around you. But I've ended up staying an extra week, and I'm probably going to end up here a couple more weeks because my apartment building, which I love my apartment, I've loved my apartment building. I really haven't had any problems so far since I have moved. But unfortunately, my apartment building randomly decided at the last minute that they were going to be doing some major construction, which, mind you, they have already been doing a couple little construction things here and there since I moved. I was like, okay, I could let it slide. Like, it's small construction, who cares? But this time it's like major construction, like floor to ceiling, loud noises, dust and fumes. Like, they have these little zipper covers over our door so that the dust and fumes can't get inside of our door. Like, major constructions or whatever. Because of that, you know, I'm not going to blame my apartment building because they didn't, it's not their fault. It's the construction people who built the building's fault. So I'm not going to blame my apartment building. I'm not going to throw shade on my actual apartment. I still like my apartment, but unfortunately, because of all the construction, it's really not a good place to bring a newborn baby because of the noise, because of the fumes, because of the dust in the air, because it's just, you know, you don't want to bring a newborn into that. So unfortunately, when we checked like a week ago, they were like, oh, it's probably going to take a total of 6 weeks. That's a long time. So currently right now, I stopped by my apartment the other day to get my computer and stuff, and they were still having construction. They still had the covers over the door and everything. So right now, I mean, I'm good here. I have everything I need here. It's not the best, most comfortable situation, but at the same time it is because I have my parents, you know, right here. So I don't even know right now how much longer I'm gonna be staying here at my parents' house. I really don't know when I'm gonna be able to go back to my apartment.
First, it's somewhere outside of Chiang Mai. It's so in deep, just give me up.
We have arrived at our early Mother's Day lunch. We decided to come back to that same Cajun place that we came with my grandma one time. I don't know if y'all remember. It's called
Cleveland's.
And it's kind of raining a little bit. I'm not even gonna put my shoes on. I brought these, but nope. No thank you. Chicken and waffles. Yes, I do. At all times.
Oh, hey, Tybee.
Like, is something wrong? But what's wrong with me looking like my daddy? What's that? What's that all about? Oh, what's that all about, grandmother? What that all about? What that all about? Oh.
You're fine.
Are you sure? Y'all sure? Y'all sure y'all want to let me hold, let her hold me? So you sure, grandmother? You sure?
Hey there, you getting some vitamin D? Some vitamin D?
Turn that way. Hello. Hello.
Say
them, take them out until my hammock.
She keeps turning.
You're turning away from the camera.
Hello. Hello.
So we are back from lunch. As you saw, it was me and my mom and my grandma and Zaya, of course, and then my aunt and her three kids. And the food was really good. I got chicken and waffles. It was really good. And then after that, we went over to my grandma's house because the restaurant was by my grandma's house. And we just hung out for a little bit so that my grandma could have some quality time. Because she hasn't really, I mean, my grandma has seen her, but she hasn't really had like some good one-on-one time with her since she was born. So that was good. And she was very well behaved throughout the whole, she was asleep through most, like half of lunch. And then when she woke up, she was just letting everybody hold her. And she was being very quiet and nice in the restaurant. And then when we went to my grandma's house, she was being really pleasant and sociable with my grandma. But once we got in the car to leave my grandma's house, she got really fussy at one point. Like, she doesn't like being strapped up in her car seat just sitting there. Like, if we're stuck in traffic and the car is not moving, she hates that. She hates it. And she was hollering and screaming so loud. And so that was a little bit worrisome. But once the car got really moving, she was fine and she fell asleep. And now we are home and we had a poopy diaper and we changed the diaper and we ate again, got a good breastfeeding in, and I swaddled her up because I know she's sleepy, but she was being really restless. So I swaddled her up so she can relax, just calm down and relax,
because I know you're a sleepy girl.
So it's about 3:18 now, and I'm just waiting for her to go to sleep. Are you gonna go to sleep, girl? Are you gonna go to sleep? So then I can put her down, and then I can edit my labor and delivery story time video. I just have my computer like on this little, what do you call these little thing? Like TV dinner tray thingies? Not tray, but like little table, fold out table. So I filmed this video yesterday and I want to edit it so I can post it tomorrow. But I need you to go down so I can have my hands free.
Stressed out.
Daddy's so mad about it.
Hey,
father.
Are you relaxed now? Are you relaxed? Hey, girl. Hey, mama's girl. Okay. See, it's okay. It's okay.
So it's 11:51 now. I usually start my morning at about 7 a.m. Of course, Zaya wakes up throughout the night, a couple of times throughout the night, but then like when she really, really wakes up kind of for the day, it's usually around like 7 a.m. Also kind of because that's when the rest of my family wakes up. My dad is getting up and getting ready for work, and my little sister is getting ready for school, and my mom is getting up to take my little sister to school. So the house kind of starts rumbling around 7 a.m. Usually like my mom will come in and take Zaya and have some cuddle time with Zaya before she leaves, because my mom takes my sister to school and then my mom goes to work. So she likes to have some quality time with Zaya before she leaves, and then she'll bring her back in around 8. Oh, Zaya, she's fussing right now because I put her down in her little thing.
Oh, you don't like it. I know you don't like it, but you have to do it. Oh.
Let me go in here so that that's not as distracting. I know it's hard to hear a baby crying, but she's fine. Trust me. Oh, sweetie Petey. Okay. So she usually wakes up around 7, and then like we have our little morning routine. I try to get some breakfast, some coffee, whatever. We go outside. What I'm trying to do right now is get her in the habit of taking a nap at a certain time. So now is that time. So I changed her, I fed her, I swaddled her, and I put her down, because she has to learn to sleep by herself, not sleeping on my chest. She has to learn to sleep by herself in her crib or in whatever she's in. So I put her down and she hates it. She hates it.
I know you hate it. I know it. Poor baby. But there's nothing wrong with you.
Okay. You stop crying as soon as I pick you up. And then as soon as I put you down to go night-night, as soon as I put you down, what are you going to do? What are you going to do when I put you down? They're going to start fussing again. But there's nothing wrong. You got to learn to be put down. Because you're spoiled. And you always fall asleep on mommy's chest. And then mommy can't get up and do anything while you're sleeping. You gotta sleep in your little thingy. You're not hungry. You're not poopy. You're just sleepy. And then as soon as I pick you up, it's fine. See? Spoiled. Why so spoiled? Okay, I just went back and fed her a little bit more just so she could get a little bit more relaxed, and I put her back down. She hasn't started fussing yet. She's not quite asleep. She's got those sleepy eyes though. Hopefully she will just go to sleep and stay relaxed and stay in there for her nap. Because I noticed that she was kind of naturally going down for a nap around noon every day. Like she'll go to sleep around 11:30 noon and then sleep till like at least 3 p.m. Which is great because if I can get her to kind of take that nap every afternoon, then that's going to be a really good time for me to be able to film videos or just get any kind of work done while she's asleep. So that's why I'm trying to get her to get on an actual schedule of making sure that she takes that nap every day so that it becomes a habit, and also making sure that she's sleeping by herself and not on top of me, because then that's pointless. I won't be able to get anything done. So yeah, today is like the first day of me really like enforcing it. Like, you are going to take a nap at this time. I am already prepared for the fact that you guys are going to have a lot of suggestions and advice for me in terms of new mom stuff, parenting stuff, what you should do with your baby, how you can get your baby to do this, what's best for babies, blah, 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 blah. I know a lot of you guys out there have kids, which is great, and I think that it's really awesome for mothers to be able to help each other out and give suggestions and stuff. Sometimes it gets overwhelming, sometimes it gets annoying when you're like not asking for help and then people are like trying to really tell you what to do. But you know, I am prepared for there to be a lot of suggestions and probably some criticism. Not even probably, I know there's going to be some criticism in the comments, but just keep in mind that this is my child, so of course I'm gonna do what I think is best. And if you see me doing something that you don't agree with or that you didn't do with your baby, I mean, it's no reason to freak out. It's no reason to throw criticism at me just because I didn't do it the way that you did it or the way that you read in some article or whatever. And like I said, I don't want the whole focus of like the whole comment section to just be, let's criticize her parenting techniques. Let's talk about her parenting techniques, because that's not fun for anybody. So hopefully that won't be too much of a problem.
Going to sleep, girl. You got a poopy diaper, girl? Do you got a poopy diaper? Oh, okay. I'm going to change you.
So it's 4:15 now. This little one just woke up and she had a poopy diaper, so I just changed her, as you saw. But yeah, nap time went well. Once she went down, she stayed down. She woke up in the middle because she pooped and then she was uncomfortable. So I changed her and I put her back down, and then she stayed asleep until now. So that was a pretty good long nap from about noon until 4. So we're doing good. We're going to try and do the same thing tomorrow, hopefully.
Are you looking at me? Are you looking at me? Hey, girl.
What's up, guys? It is Tuesday morning. It's 9:30 in the morning. As I was explaining yesterday, I've been up since like 7 whenever everybody went to work and school. I gave Zaya her breakfast, breastfed her, and now she's taking a little nap in the bed right now. So I was gonna use this time wisely to get myself some breakfast. I have my little cat dress pajama thingies on. I don't know what I want for breakfast, but I better hurry up because I know Zaya is gonna wake up any minute now, and then I will have my hands full. I really need to get a baby carrier. I got a baby carrier at my baby shower, the Katan, something like that. It's one of those wrap ones, and it's really good. It's like the most top rated baby carrier, but it's a size medium, and I think I actually need like an extra small because it doesn't fit me. Like if I try to put Zaya in it, she'll just like fall out because it's too loose. But it fits my mom, and my mom tried it, and it actually works really good, and Zaya seems to like it once she gets like situated in there. She likes being carried around there because it hugs her close to your chest, and that's how she likes to be held anyway. So I need to get one of those in my size, that way, you know, throughout the day or whatever, I can put her in the carrier and have her, you know, close to my chest and have her be comfortable, but also have my hands free so I can, you know, make breakfast, eat breakfast. I could even probably sit down and edit a video if she's being quiet, but she usually is quiet, like especially if she's being carried, she'll be dead silent. She's not really a crying baby at all, which is awesome. Got my little fruit for breakfast, but I think somebody is fussing. I think somebody's up. Are you waking up?
No.
Oh, stretch, stretch, stretch. Are you gonna open your eyes? Oh. Are you gonna open your eyes or are you gonna stay asleep? But yeah, whenever I let her sleep in the bed, I just make sure that I put her in the middle of the bed. And this is like a queen size bed, so there's like plenty of surrounding room. She can't even like roll over at this point. But I just put her in the middle of the bed and like make like a little barrier of like pillows and blankets around, just to make sure that it's safe. But she really sleeps really well on this mattress because it's like really comfortable. And just put the blanket on and make sure that there's no, you know, hazards around. She stays in one spot. She can't move around at this point. She's still too little. Oh, are you gonna wake up or not? I wanna know. Somebody just peed on the bed. Somebody just peed on the bed when I was changing the diaper on the bed. Is that funny? That's not funny. That is not funny.
Oh, what is it? What is it? Little fuzzy girl. Little fuzzy girl.
It's a little bit later on Tuesday now, and me and Zaya are just sitting outside enjoying the peaceful sun, the sunshine, and the wind, and the birds chirping. Oh, you're not comfortable. Hold on.
Oh, it's okay. I know.
That was not a comfortable position for me to be holding you. I know. I'm still mastering how to hold a baby and hold a camera at the same time. It's harder than it looks.
Is it cold?
Hey, pumpkin.
I look mad.
It's a mean mugging.
So it's about noon on Wednesday. Nothing exciting or interesting has happened so far today. Just our same morning routine. Everybody goes to school and work. I stay home with Zaya. She naps on and off. I eat breakfast. I watch a lot of HGTV and Food Network and Cooking Channel. And that's about it. That's what I do every day, what I've been doing every day. But I wanted to check in. I know a big thing with pregnancies is the snapback. Everybody is like, oh, I want to get my body back. Oh, you know, how much weight did you gain? How are you going to lose weight? Are you blah, blah. You know, that's always a big thing with pregnancies. For me, that probably wouldn't have been anything that I would have been worried about anyway, because I've just never been a huge, like, fitness person, a huge body conscious person, probably because I've been the same size my whole life. Like, once I got to my adult size, it never fluctuated, like, no matter what I did. My body is just very, I can't think of the word, but this is the motion, just very stable, stagnant. Like, my body never changes. Like, my body barely changed throughout my pregnancy. The only thing that pretty much changed throughout my pregnancy was my actual belly. I don't know, but I eat a lot. I don't always eat healthy. I mean, I have a fast metabolism. That's the only thing I can really say. Like, right before I gave birth, I would say I was about 150. No, I think I was 155. Yeah, I think I was 155 at my heaviest, right before I gave birth. And before I got pregnant, I was 135. I gained 20 pounds throughout my pregnancy. Currently, I am almost 4 weeks postpartum. Zaya is almost 4 weeks old. So 3 more days until she is 1 month old. So I thought it would be interesting to weigh myself and see how much I weigh, if I went all the way back down to my previous weight or what. So my mom has a little scale. It's probably not as accurate as the scales at the doctor, which is the only thing that I was using before. But let's see. Wait for it to zero out and 136.9, which I should probably take this big robe off. Maybe that will make a difference. I don't know. I'm trying to be accurate here. Oh, it went down. Maybe this scale is pretty accurate. 135.5. So, wow, that's pretty amazing. That's pretty amazing. Not because of the weight loss, but because it's like an exact weight loss. Like, I was 135, gained 20 pounds after birth, exactly back down to 135. Like, that's pretty crazy. So that just goes to show you that pretty much all my pregnancy weight was literally just belly. Once Zaya was out, that was pretty much all my extra weight. So I'm back down to my normal weight. Like I said, I don't really care. Honestly, if I'm being honest, I wish I would have gained weight. If anything, I wish I would have gained weight, because I think I could use a little extra, you know, a little extra in some places, but whatever, I'm fine with it.
Worry about that and just work on the rest of the meal. I'm starting by making a pesto mixture to rub inside my pork loin. It has some pine nuts in it, which I've toasted in a dry steel pan to get together.
It's with the trees.
It's Thursday morning, 9:15 a.m. Going through the usual morning routine, but this time I'm making French toast. Ghetto French toast. Ratchet French toast, since it's Raven's Ratchet Kitchen. You don't need no recipe for this. You just need an egg and some milk and some bread and some butter and some cinnamon. Crack an egg. Add a splash of milk. Add a dash of cinnamon. Two slices. And you soak it. Soak it, soak it, soak it. Soak it, soak it, soak it. Let that soak for a little bit while you heat up your pan. Is it hard to wake up? Well, let's see if I can make one-handed French toast. Got my butter melted. Lift that baby over. This is probably about done. Oh yeah. And put it on the plate. And there you have it. Ratchet French toast. Are you gonna let me eat? Are you gonna let me eat in peace? Are you gonna start fussing? Don't start that fussing. Wow, she let me eat my whole breakfast without fussing. What are you doing, Maxwell? You know you're not supposed to be on there.
What are you doing? Are you just chilling? Are you just chilling by yourself? What's wrong with your hair, girl? You got a little piece of fuzz right here. Hey, girl, are you laughing? Are you laughing and smiling? Are you laughing and smiling? Wow.
I can't believe I just caught that on camera like that. I can never catch it on camera when she does that. And it's crazy because I, like whenever she was like 1-2 weeks old, she would just like, she would like rarely randomly do like a little smile when like in her sleep, like when she was sleeping, you might catch her like do a little smile, but she would never smile when she was awake. And of course she wasn't like, you know, when you're a newborn, you don't have any like personality or emotions besides just crying really, because you're, that hasn't developed yet. But she, I noticed that she would smile in her sleep. So I Googled it and I found out that like newborns, sometimes they smile in their sleep. A lot of people think that it's because they have gas, but it's actually not gas that's causing them to make that face. It really is a smile, but it's kind of like in their sleep, like their brain is kind of practicing their emotions and practicing smiling and stuff like that. Oh, don't start fussing now. So sometimes when they're sleeping, it's like their brain goes into like practice mode. I don't know, it's kind of weird. And then it usually takes a couple of months for them to actually really learn how to smile and for their brain to understand like what smiling means, like something actually making them smile. Like if you're playing with them or you're talking to them or you're tickling them and then they start laughing and smiling, it takes a few months for them to develop that emotion or whatever. So on the article that I read, they said that I think they said anywhere from like 3 to 5 months old that they will actually really start responding to you and start smiling and like know that they're smiling when they're awake. But this little one is not even 1 month old yet, almost 1 month old, and she's been smiling like while she's wide awake. She's been smiling and even kind of like laughing like how she just did. I feel like she's a baby genius. Your eye looks like it's getting a little bit better. I'm not gonna say a rough first couple of weeks because it really wasn't anything like too major, but whenever she was about like a week old, I noticed that her eye was having like those eye boogers, like really bad, like when you get pink eye. And I was like, does she have pink eye? Because that looks like last time I had pink eye, that's what it looked like. And I showed my mom and she was like, yeah, we have to ask the doctor about it or whatever. And so she is just like a little eye infection. It's pretty common for newborns to get little eye infections, either from it being like a bacterial, like pink eye type thing, or sometimes their tear duct right here is clogged and it causes that gooey stuff to come out. So we told her pediatrician and she gave us some antibiotic cream to put on her eye. So I've been putting that on her eye for the past couple of weeks. Yeah. Are you looking at me? Are you looking at me? And I felt really bad, but I guess it's not, you know, the doctor said it's not that big of a deal. It looks like it's getting better. And then on top of that, she also had to get a tongue tie clipping procedure, a frenectomy. I forgot what the scientific word is, but basically when I first started breastfeeding her, when they like kind of taught me how to do it in the hospital, it seemed like everything was going good. But then like after a week of being home with her trying to breastfeed, I noticed that it was starting to get a little bit painful, and I was like, I don't know if she's latching on good, or I don't know what the problem is, but I know it's not supposed to really be painful for me. And then I was feeding her one time, and then she spit up, which, you know, babies spit up all the time, it's fine. But when she spit up, I looked and it was bloody, and it kind of scared me at first. I was like, is she spitting up blood? And I called my mom to come see. And then I realized, okay, wait, my nipples are bleeding. It's my blood that she's spitting up. And my nipples were just really sore and chapped and cracked and bleeding. And it was really hurting. And of course, you feed like 8 times a day. And every time you do it, it just gets worse and more painful. So I went to a lactation specialist, you know, breastfeeding expert basically, and I had a little session with her to kind of learn how to get her to latch on properly so that she's not rubbing me the wrong way. But what we found out was the reason why, or part of the reason why she wasn't latching on good, was because of the way her tongue was. You know how you have that little string tendon thing underneath your tongue that kind of keeps it from going all over the place? Like, I don't know if you can see mine, but if you feel underneath your tongue, you'll feel that little string thing. Well, apparently on hers, it was like really short and really tight, to where it wasn't really letting her tongue move around very much. It was like tying her tongue down. It's called a tongue tie. A tongue tie? Yeah. I'm talking about you. I'm talking about you. She's looking at me like, you talking about me? And basically the way that you fix that is you have to take the little baby to the dentist, and they have a laser gun thing where they slice it and release the string so that the tongue can be free. And when I heard that, I was like, no, I don't want to do that. Like, oh my gosh, I don't want to take my little newborn and get her tongue like lasered. Like, oh my gosh. But they reassured me that it's really not painful. It takes like 2 minutes to do it. It's like really not that big of a deal. Like, they really are in very little pain, blah, blah, blah. So I was like, okay. So I took her to the dentist and we got it lasered, and she did such a good job. Did such a good job. Like, she really, of course she cried. Because first of all, you had to hold her down and hold her mouth open and laser it. I went with my mom, and I had my mom go in there when they actually did it. And I stayed outside the room because I couldn't watch. I did not want to watch that. But she cried for like a couple of minutes. And then afterward, like literally immediately afterwards in the dentist's office, I breastfed her and she was fine. And then we took her back for her follow-up appointment. Which that was like last week, and they said everything looks good. It healed up really good. And now she's breastfeeding like a champ. She's latching on really good. Now she's to the point where I don't even have to like guide her or like help her get the nipple in her mouth or anything. She could just boop, go for it herself. And she latches on really, really good, and it doesn't hurt me at all. So I guess it worked. I mean, I know it worked. It was just a lot because she had an eye infection and she had her tongue procedure at the same time. And what else? And she's been kind of having some, why are you throwing your head back like that? She's kind of had some tummy rumbling gas issues, which, you know, babies always have gas, but sometimes it seems like she has like really big gas bubbles and it bothers her. So we give her some little baby gas medicine to help with that. But it was just, she was just having a little bit of a tough time because all these things was happening all at once, and I was just so uncomfortable. I was also thinking about the other day that my vlogs are gonna be so annoying, not even for you, but for me, when I'm editing them and when I'm watching them back, because I'm gonna hear myself talking in a baby voice the whole time. First of all, I don't even like my regular voice. Like, my regular voice annoys me. So talking in a baby voice is like 10 times worse. I know it's gonna be probably annoying for you guys, but it's gonna be annoying for me too. I need to like try not to talk in a baby voice the whole time. But it's so hard. It's so hard to have a baby and not talk in a baby voice like all the time. So Zaya is down for her afternoon nap over there. and I am here just writing down some notes and some lists like I like to do. I am a note taker and a list maker. Right now I am writing down some notes for my mommy makeover, which yes, I'm still talking about, still excited about, still planning on doing. Just kind of different things I want to get done and blah, blah, blah. I'm saying this like I'm getting surgery. It's not surgery. It's just like little getting my hair done and stuff like that and where I want to get it done. And I'm just having a little Amy's enchilada TV dinner thing that I've told y'all about before. And a lot of y'all have told me that y'all tried them and y'all like them. I love it when like y'all try the things that I recommend and y'all say that y'all like it. I think that's pretty cool. So I'm just trying to, you know, get back on track, get myself together, get my life together, get my work together, and writing lists and planning things out and putting my goals down in writing really helps me do that. So yeah. Oh, and I had to change my pajamas because Zaya spit up on me 3 times in a row. And at that point I was like, I need to change. And I just live in these little nightgown dresses, spaghetti strap, stretchy, low cut dresses like this that you can sleep in. I've literally been living in them since Zaya was born because they're so easy to just boop breastfeed with and they're so comfortable. Yes, I've been around the house in these like every single day. I have like 3 of them and I just keep wearing them and washing them and wearing them and washing them. Tricky part about being a single mom, there's that phrase again that you guys don't like me to use. More on that later. Maybe, maybe not, probably not. But anyway, y'all know what I mean. Me being here alone with Zaya, whatever you want to call that, is taking a shower. I've pretty much got down to a science where I can use the bathroom really fast. So if I put her down in her little rocker or something, I can run, use the bathroom. I've gotten to where I can use the bathroom in record time and I can run back out and not feel anxious about it. But taking a shower, I'm really not a very fast shower taker. And you know, even when I try to take a fast shower, it just seems like it's gonna be at least 10 minutes. At least 10 minutes is like the fastest that I can probably take a shower. But with a newborn baby just kind of sitting there unattended while you're in the shower and the water is running and you can't hear, I think that's really the main thing, is that when you're in the shower, you really can't hear anything that's going on outside of the bathroom. So that's really an anxious situation for me to leave her in her, like right now she's sleeping. She's sleeping in her rocker in the living room. Where she always sleeps and she's very comfortable and there's no fall risk or anything, so she really should be fine. But you know, I just feel I don't want to, you know. Okay, this is actually gonna be my first time doing this because usually I will hold off on showering altogether until my mom is here and she can be with Zaya. But I haven't showered in 2 whole days at this point. 2 whole days? Yeah, 2 whole days at this point. I feel disgusting. I feel itchy. I feel disgusting. No need for further explanation. And I really need to take a shower. And my mom is gonna stay late at work today. So like this cannot, I can't do this any longer. So I'm really wasting time right now by trying to vlog about it. So I'm just gonna go. I made it, I did it. I think that was about a 7-minute shower. I literally rushed out in my towel. And she's still sleeping. Okay, now I gotta hurry up and get dressed. So it's 6:15 p.m. now and Zaya is just now waking up. Of course, I just let her sleep as long as she wanted to. She's been asleep since about noon and it's 6:15 now. Are you smiling? What? Anyway, I can't. Look at what are you doing? Look at your face. No, it does not funny. Oh my gosh, I can't even talk. Oh my gosh, I came to show you how crusty, how crusty her mouth is. From sleeping all day, she was drooling. And it dried on the corner of her mouth, and now she looks like a little crackhead with the white crust right there. I've never seen your mouth get so crusty before. You were sleeping for so long. Oh, that's an ugly face. Okay, okay. I stop making fun of you now. I stop making fun of you now.
What are you saying? Are you holding your head up?
When the diaper overflows. Yeah, I'm sure you're mad. Just finished giving her a bath. She hated it, but I successfully did it. That was my first time giving her a bath without my mom helping me, so I feel pretty accomplished. But look at this. I know this is disgusting. I mean, to me, it's not really that disgusting because it's not like real poop. It's baby poop, so it's just like yellow liquid. So I feel like y'all can deal with it. But look how it looks like tie-dye. Her onesie was soaked through the back and through the side, onto the sheets, onto the blanket. So yeah, she needed a bath, and now I have to wash everything. So it is Friday afternoon, about 4 o'clock. My mom got off of work and we are finally going shopping. I think I've been saying that for the past couple of days that we wanted to go shopping. We are finally going. Saya is all strapped up in the car seat. She's sleeping. And yeah, we're probably just, I mean, I don't know where exactly we're gonna go. Probably just to Target, to be honest, but this will be one of my first times really going anywhere since she was born. So it's always good to just get out of the house, period. And I left my water bottle on the roof of the car, apparently. Oops.
Zaya, welcome to Target.
My first trip to Target, starting when I'm young. Is that fun?
Where am I? That's just me.
Now that grandma's got Zaya, I can show y'all what I got from Target. This is the first little dress that I got. It's a little white baby doll with little straps. I think it's so cute. And it has a little gold foil design on it. So, you know, that's why I picked it, because it's like shiny and gold. And it's like little elephants and leaves. I don't know if y'all can see that. It's like terrible light in here, I know, but whatever. And then this was on clearance, so I went ahead and got it because it was on clearance for like $5. And it's just a little zip-up hoodie. It has a little hood on it, and it's a gray hoodie with like this really cute floral design on it. It's 0 to 3 months size, so it's too big for her right now, but she will be that size very soon. This little dress set, because like I said, she needed a couple of dresses because she has a couple of little special occasions coming up that she needs dresses for, and she doesn't really have any dresses. Like, she mostly got all just regular onesies in her size right now. So I got this little set, which has this really cute striped dress, and it came with little white bloomers underneath, and then this little polka dotted, this is actually not a dress, it's actually a onesie, but it kind of looks like a dress with the ruffles at the bottom, and it's like coral with little pink polka dots on it. I mostly just wanted this set for this dress. I didn't really like this one as much, but it's cute too. And then the last thing is this little dress, which is navy blue with little pink pineapples on it. I think this is the one that she's probably gonna wear to the wedding, maybe? Or maybe this one. Or no, maybe this one. I don't know which one she's gonna wear to which thing, but she has a couple of options, and this one came with little navy blue bloomers too. And each one of these, this was $8. This set of two was, I think, like $11. Yeah. The little hoodie, like I said, was on sale for $5. And the little gold dress was $12. But then we went to Zara, and I bought myself just a little black dress, like just a plain little black dress, nothing special. You'll see that later. But I went to the Zara Kids section, which obviously was like my first time going to the Zara Kids section. And they don't really have a lot of like baby clothes, but it's mostly like kid sizes and toddler sizes. But they had these little pants, these little coral pants with little palm trees on it, and it has a little kangaroo pocket on the front, and the little drawstring, they're just so cute. I couldn't resist. So they're obviously too big for her right now, but she will grow into them and they will be really cute. And these were $16. So a little pricey, $16 for just like a little tiny pair of pants, but I mean, she deserves it, right? Saturday morning. Poop explosion number two. Is that funny? Is that funny? Gotta take all the clothes off.
No more worrying about pooping.
Now that I finally learned how to poop, I'm gonna show you guys how it's done.
Right now, talking about me, I know how. I know how.
So it's 1 p.m. on Saturday now. And I have not eaten today yet, and I have not peed today yet, and I really have to pee, and I am really hungry, but I really don't want to get up because you like that. Do you got the hiccups? Do you got the hiccups? Do you got the hiccups? Do you got the hiccups, girl? No language can express the power, beauty, heroism, and majesty of a mother's love. Happy Mother's Day to Zaya's mom, to Raven Elise, the gorgeous beauty. Best wishes from my first wig and RPG show. I wasn't expecting that. It's from RPG show. That's so sweet. Thank you, RPG show. I know Wincy watches my videos. Maybe I'll see them. They're so pretty. So it is Sunday, May 8th, which means it is Mother's Day, which means it is officially my first Mother's Day as a mother, obviously. We celebrated Mother's Day, obviously, last weekend with my grandma and my aunt, but today is the real Mother's Day, and we are going to celebrate again just with my immediate family. We're gonna go out for lunch.
Sleepy girl.
Look at how she held in her hands.
That's the best way to be.
Yes, for all of us.
She's like, man, I don't know about you guys, but she looks all set.
There, I got my real outfit on. I got a dress on and a cardigan.
Cal Pigment. How you doing?
About to leave. Those socks. These socks ain't worth a darn. Mama. Hi, Mama. So funny because your hair is so dark. And your hair never looks.
Is it her hair dark?
My hair was like this color. We are at P.F. Chang's, by the way.
Got a lot of excessive eyes. Mover.
This box is very inconspicuous. I don't know if it even says it on the box, does it?
It says nothing.
It says something. Are you kidding me? Are you freaking kidding me? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. It's something about Apple.
Apple what?
I'm just fixing it. Can't be. Yeah. Oh my gosh! Are you kidding? Thank you! And it's purple.
Not drunk to be.
I can't believe you! And what's this?
It's a charger thing so you don't have to plug it in.
Oh my gosh! Thank you so much!
It on top.
I love it! Thank you! Wow, I hadn't even looked into what they do. I was like, I'm not gonna get one of these.
Well, when I heard you mention it, I knew you wouldn't get it for yourself.
Oh my gosh.
Hurdy. You can like tuck that under. Cool.
I have no idea.
It's cute.
I love it. Hi, Boo-Boo. Did you have fun today? Did you have fun today?
I guess so. But,
Say hi, Uncle PJ.
You know it, I guess.
Hi, Uncle PJ. Look at that pretty girl.